So Professor Yu Kongjian, you are the principal and founder of Turenscape. Your work has contributed to, especially with the notion and technique of sponge city, has contributed to completely transforming the discipline of landscape architecture. And you have also introduced some transformational pedagogical ways to teach landscape infrastructure in China. So I would like to ask you to open our panel with a presentation of key projects you would like to share with the audience.
Thank you. Thank you, Beatrice. It is a great honor to share my thinking about landscape today. I can see you talk about the beautiful picture about Chinese royal painting from royal family. But today, the landscape culture I'm talking is totally opposite, totally different, which is a landscape of production, productivity, healing, and adaptation, not just pressure making, not just beauty. But how can you make this kind of landscape also beautiful? Now, that's challenging for today. We all enjoy this fruit of industrial civilization. At the same time, we suffer its byproducts, including the planet itself. The conventional solution to deal with this problem we are facing today, flood, drought, habitat loss, and so on, is this we call the gray infrastructure. Concrete, stronger and stronger concrete, walls, channelizing the river, aqueduct, and the concrete pipe system. Now, this kind of gray infrastructure can be very effective, very short and short-sighted. But usually, they increase the risk, higher risk of disaster of nature. Meanwhile, create more carbon emissions. You can see, so we are talking about cutting carbon emissions today, carbon credit, carbon trading. But actually, carbon emission increasing dramatically. I can expect in the next 20 years, you will see more carbon emission. It's too late already. It's urgency to have adaptation solution, which is nature-based solution. I call sponge planet. Use water instead of carbon, or in addition to carbon, as a solution, as a key solution to solve today's problems, holistic solutions, which was, I imagine, the planetary landscape. Three strategies, which are totally opposite to the conventional solution, which is slow down water, retention, retain water, slow down water, and adapt water. Those strategies are totally opposite to the conventional solution. Conventionally, we build a dam to accumulate water, channelize the river, flush away the flood, and build a high wall to fight against water. But today, it's a nature-based landscape, totally opposite. And this kind of solution is based on the lower culture of landscape. Not as a higher culture, not beautiful paintings, but this farming, water management, adaptation, that I call the survival skill, the survival art of landscape. Use a very simple tool to transform the landscape from the slope to the delta, such as terracing, ponding, diking and ponding, and islanding to create landscape which are productive, sustainable, beautiful, and biodiverse. Now, apply this kind of technique, upgrading this ancient wisdom. I have been tried for the past 25 years and built over 1,000 projects in more than 200 cities in China. Solves the problem of flood, drought, habitat loss, and a beautiful park for the city. I just want to give you two of these kind of projects in the same city. Sanya, the tropical island in South China. One is about healing the city by building a sponge city right in the middle of the city by terracing, ponding, islanding. Create a simple, very simple technique. Create a sponge in the middle of the city. That's the execution of this scheme. 2 years later, you create a beautiful park, forest over the lake, skywalk above the canopy, and underneath, you will have a beautiful habitat for biodiversity. Mm-hmm. This comparison before and after. In just 4 years, we were able to transform this floodable area into a beautiful urban center, right in the middle of the city. That you can see under the canopy, people walk underneath during the dry season, during the monsoon season, you have beautiful place that can regulate 1 million cubic meters of storm water and save the city. That's before, and this is after. And catalyst, a new urban center in Sanya. Another example is how can your nature-based solution, instead of building higher and higher and wall to protect the city from being flooded by the sea level rising, we actually move the seawall and introduce the water into the city. That's the site, and that was the seawall. You can see introduces the salty water and meet with the fresh water. We create this blackish water, and that's a habitat for mangrove to get established. So one side is for the habitat, the other side for people to use the park. Now that's about 3 years later. You have a large vegetation, and you create this beautiful park, and at the same time, you have this resilient waterfront. Certainly, architecture play a key role here, allow people to enjoy the landscape. That's today's landscape. So we are talking about the city and the nature. So that's the future. How can we heal the byproducts of the industrial civilization? Meanwhile, how can we adapt the changing planet? That's the future landscape. Thank you.